Hey, what's up? Welcome back to the channel. I'm back from camera camp. So I never made a video before camera camp saying that I was going, but in fact I did. It was a great time. Went all the way out to Montana for this event, and I had an incredible time meeting all kinds of other creators, photographers, videographers, YouTubers, all that, of various sizes, and some really well known, some completely unknowns like myself. It was a great experience. I got to use all kinds of the Sony equipment. I'm normally a Canon user, like I'm using here now, or this here, right? I'm normally fully Canon, but this was a great opportunity to learn a completely different system. I got a great appreciation for what Sony has done with their cameras and see certain things that I would love to see Canon implement into theirs. I'm not really contemplating a switch. I'm so well invested into Canon. I mean, some pretty expensive stuff that I've invested in, so I don't plan on switching it anytime soon. But with that said, it was a great time, great experience, great to use that equipment and have an idea of how it works if I would ever use it in the future. Now, all that said, I took all kinds of photos and videos throughout the trip, and I've got all my photos. You've probably been seeing them on my Instagram, but all my videos were on two SD cards that I somehow ended up leaving on the plane on the way home, and they weren't even like on my flight into St. John, so it wasn't like potentially that I could go back to the airport there and ask some people at Air Canada if it was found. It was just submitting the claim. It was from like Calgary to Toronto flight, and supposedly they're still looking for them. I don't know. I hope they find them, because it would be nice to have the footage, but in reality I didn't take a whole lot. I didn't try to like vlog it or anything. But what we're going to do with this video is just run through the trip through photos, more so than a video. So I've kind of put together all kinds of photos from different landscapes that I shot to some photos of some other people that were there. I got to meet some great people. We'll be friends for life now. Great experience overall. Let's just jump into some of the video or photos. So I took two flights to get there. I flew through from St. John's to Montreal, and then Montreal to Calgary. And then I would drove more than 5 hours, probably about 5.5 hours from Calgary down to Big Fork, Montana, where the camp was happening. That was an experience. It was basically a full day of travel just to get to where the camp was happening. So I did that on the Friday. And then on Friday evening, I met with another guy who was going to the camp. His name is Dave from Vancouver. So it was cool to be able to meet up with someone ahead of time. Didn't do any photo or video that evening, and just got some supper, and then planned for the next day when he and I and a couple others were also going to go out to Glacier National Park, and we were going to do a boat tour on Lake McDonald, which is one of the bigger lakes out in Glacier National Park. So we planned all that out Friday evening. So then Saturday morning we got going. I got up really early because 3.5 hour time change, so really early for me wasn't really early at all. So I got out and I made this photo, got together with the guys, we went out, met up with some other people out there, went for a small hike, some photos from that. It was a 1,000 foot elevation gain, so we didn't end up going very far before we turned around. It was 1,000 foot elevation gain over something like 3 miles, so it was a bit nuts. It was just straight uphill. So we went up a little ways, got a few photos, and then decided to come on back around. So that was just the three of us that went out together and went on this little bit of a hike. So then we went and looked around at the lake a little bit, went into the lodge there and got lunch. An elk burger. It was the first time having elk. I've eaten a few other game meats before. This is a little different, and it was really good. It was not much different than beef, really, but it was good. I don't really know how to describe it. And right after lunch, then was time for the tour, and we met up with a couple other creators. So at this point, I had met up with two others, Dave and Chris, and we had went out to Lake McDonald together. And when we were out there, we met up with a couple others. We met up with Marlise and Ashton, and Ashton's friend who was there with him. She was just along for the ride. So together we all went out on the boat tour, got to know each other a little bit there, and then right after we walked around a little bit, taking some more photos. No one was in a rush, we didn't really have any plans, so we just kind of hung out together, took some photos, and had a good time. So I took lots of photos of the others. It was a lot of fun just being able to be there, just everyone having similar ideas, similar interests in terms of photography and videography, so it was cool being able to do that together. So after we left Lake McDonald, we went on back to Big Fork, four of us, me, Dave, Chris and Marlise. I went to this one little area that's very old westerny kind of vibes. Shot a few photos around there. It's a really cool area. I think it's best experienced in person. I didn't find there was a great way to capture it in photo. Maybe if I knew it a little better, I'd be able to come up with a better way to do it, but It was mostly just an in-person thing. It was just a really cool experience. It was just felt old Western. If the roads weren't paved, it would feel like you're way back in those Western movies kind of thing. So that just about did it for the afternoon. We all kind of went our separate ways for a couple hours. But then around 7 o'clock, we all got together at this restaurant and bar in the hotel that Chris was staying at. And a couple other people were staying there as well. But we got a bigger, much bigger group this time, probably about 15 people all together. Got to get together, talk about different things that were happening, be it on YouTube and Instagram, specifically the camp. It was a great experience. I didn't capture any photos of this, and maybe it would have been cool to document this, what was going on, but it would have been a vlog sort of thing, and I didn't really do it. So it was a great experience to just be there and talk to all these people and have this experience with them. But that just about did it for Saturday. So we got into what was really the main thing that we were all there for, and that was camera camp on Sunday. So this was extremely exciting for everybody. So I got to the camp around 7:45, maybe a little bit earlier, maybe about 7:40 in the morning. Breakfast was slated to start at 8:00. So I got there. I think I was the first one there of any of the people that I knew already, that I met already. Got there, got checked in. Went ahead and grabbed some gear. So I picked up an A7R 4 and a 16-35 2.8, and along with an RX 0 Mark II. Since I was going kayaking, I was gonna put that on the front. Of course, the 26 gigs of video that I took on that thing are completely lost, but that's no big deal. But while I was checking out some gear, it was really cool. I ran into Becky and Chris. They're a couple of YouTubers who are actually originally from Newfoundland as well. They live in Buffalo right now, but they're very much Newfoundlanders, so it was really cool to be able to meet them. There's a couple of people that I know that Chris knows, so it was really cool to be able to just have an interaction with someone that, you know, was from home. So you seem to run into Newfoundlanders everywhere. So then we had breakfast. Justine and Jenna kind of introduced the camp, and they talked for a few minutes just about all the different things that were happening and, you know, how it kind of pumped up the whole day, although I don't think we really needed much of that because we were all pretty excited. So I started the day out with my first activity. I was doing kayaking. There was only two of us went kayaking at 9 a.m. There were a couple more times when there was kayaking offered, but at 9 a.m. there's only two of us went. Myself and another guy named Daniel, we went out together. We kind of did our own thing out there, but I was able to get a pretty cool one of him kayaking here and some cool ones of the birds. So that was a great experience. So the next thing I did after that was I went hiking. It was a guided hike up along this river, some great scenes up on the side of the riverbed. And it was a really cool experience too, because the guy that was guiding, he wasn't originally from Montana, but he was working at the lodge there. He was able to give a little bit of insight as to what it's like in Montana a little bit, and gave a little bit of background on it. So that was really cool to do, and we got to exchange some stories about where we're from and things like that. So it was really refreshing to just sip, you know, stop and just have a chat with someone for a bit. So we did that for a little bit as we hiked out. There's a couple spots we stopped, took some really nice photos and videos. Right now, we are along the side of a river, shooting some photos, some videos, some cool shots. It's pretty great. It reminds me of Manuel's River home, but just a lot bigger, longer. Really nice. Sun is out, so it's tough for a lot of photos, but it's nice. So after that, we went back to the lodge. It was lunchtime, and so we spent a bit of time at that. Then after lunch, I went and took part in a DJI Ronin class, so I got to use the Ronin SC. During this, I really only took video, of course, because it was meant for video as a stabilizer, so I don't have any photos from that. But then following that, we did a video scavenger hunt about 2:30 to 6:00, so we had, this is a long time that we did this video scavenger hunt, but it blew by because we were having a blast doing it. I was on Team Justine, and I was with like something like 10 or 11 other people besides Justine, and together we had to pick up a few different clips. This one guy, his name is Say Park, he put together this insane hyperlapse. I still can't get over it, like it was absolutely nuts. But we had a bunch of great people all working together, and it was really cool to be able to work alongside of Justine, not only just the other, you know, small creators like myself, but to work with someone like Justine, who is so well known in the YouTube community, actually get to suggest things to her. It was just a crazy experience to be able to do that, and one that's just absolutely insane. So then that kind of created, I guess, a bond between her and all the people that were on the team. So it was someone that we were able to talk to a bit later, and she knew who we were. So that was really cool. So after the video scavenger hunt, we had a bit of time. For an hour, it was happy hour, and then supper right after that. So towards the end of supper, around 8 o'clock or so, Jen and Justine got up and announced that they were going to be putting the winning video out soon. They were getting ready to, Sony was getting ready to do that. A few people that were representing Sony had put this together and were preparing this. So it was pretty exciting. It ended up that the video that they showed wasn't actually the winning video. They just compiled a bunch of parts from everybody's videos, kind of like the best of everything. But it ended up we didn't win anyway once they did announce the winners. So that's too bad. The people that did win absolutely deserved it. They put together some pretty incredible clips as well. So, but after that was all said and done, there were just a couple more things to go. The last thing that I was doing was a light painting class with a photographer who works for Sony named Eldeen. It was pretty crazy to see. Like, I do quite a bit of long exposures. Like, you'll see this a lot on my Instagram. You'll see long exposures, mostly with light trails from cars, for the most part. But I'd always been interested in doing light painting just to do something that's a little different. So it was really cool being able to, like, actually see this done, actually do it. So we created a few nice light painting photos, and then we all kind of started looking at the stars. There was an astrophotography class going on as well, but we all kind of started looking at the stars, and so he got us to do a little bit of that as well. Some of my favorite photos that I made all weekend during that little bit of astrophotography. So at this point, it's about 10:30 at night, and camp was cluing up, and so we're kind of just saying our goodbyes, cluing up everything, and so I made sure I got my picture with Justine, because I absolutely had to, especially after working with her on these video scavenger hunt. I couldn't leave without getting a picture with at least her. So made sure that happened, and then I was off back to my Airbnb, packed up all my things to get ready for the next morning. I had to get on the go I woke up about 5 o'clock in the morning in order to drive back to Calgary to catch my flight to Toronto, where I lost my SD cards, and then my flight from Toronto to St. John's. But all in all, it was an absolutely incredible experience. Thank you, iJustine. Thank you, Jenna. Thank you, Sony Alpha, for putting this thing together, coming up with this idea, and bringing out people other than just the big name creators, and getting some other people involved. It was an absolutely incredible experience, and I hope that we can come back again next year, because it was way too much fun, and I need to do it again. Slowly.